StudyItOnline.com/LiveWire.
Relationships and sex parties. Talking about news story Spiegel did. 1,000 American adults were questioned, I guess, during this study.
Did Mike hand you the poll?
Yes, he did. It's quite a poll.
All over.
And what were the findings? It looks like 14%. Would you ever consider being in an open relationship? 14% said yes. And would you ever attend a party where people engage in sexual activity with multiple partners? 9% said yes. Have you ever been in an open relationship? 13% said yes.
Now, that's a party I'd go to. I wouldn't participate, but I mean, I'd bring a hot dish and
you go alone
or just
with
kick
some,
back.
Yeah. So you wouldn't go with a partner.
Not like Mike and I, where we'd all, you know, we'd all roll in with some sixers and maybe one of his dips, and then we'd just kick back and then let some eyes wide shut action happen in front of us, huh? Couple
See,
of
I don't think they let solos come into those kind of parties.
Damn it!
You got to bring it. You got to bring a significant other.
Ah, you got to bring a dish.
Somebody to share. Yeah, that kind of dish.
Oh, that type of dish. Oh, Michael, we were waiting for your stance.
I'm too insecure and
the show
jealous.
Deviant.
I could. I mean, part of me would like that sort of lifestyle, like any guy, you know, because obviously. You know, having...
From the outside looking in, it looks amazing, but then once you get in there, it's not as, I don't think it's as glamorous. There's certain people that can pull it off that are very open sexually, very secure in themselves. Like you said, you're very insecure and very jealous. Like that would, it would destroy me. I could never do it.
Yeah. I wish I wasn't, but yeah, I know it would eat at me.
I'm going to regret this.
Oh God.
But I don't care. And this is for you, Scott. You want to keep it real?
I just want you to be you, Justin. That's all. Just be you.
Here's why it could go so wrong. A 19-year-old Justin, so many years ago, might have had a situation with an ex.
Yeah.
Who I haven't spoken to in a decade. Where here is a concern that people don't think about.
Right, there's lots of
things. Oh, there's a real big concern.
Yeah. Many layers to these types of things.
Let's just say some drinks were drank, some jokes were had, jokes went and got serious, serious turned into doors locking. And let's say there might have been a second gentleman around that was a dear friend. No, it was the devils. It was the devils.
I don't know what that means. You let your friend...
Dude, girl, dude. That's all I'm leaving.
So it was you and your girlfriend, and you let your buddy join in.
And let's just say...
You ended up on the outside.
He would have put you to shame. All of a sudden, so like, you just see him unveil this... What is that?
Oh, yeah, so your self-esteem plummets.
Right.
Destroys.
That's my point.
Destroy the one time... In my ute as a teen, I dabbled. It was an absolute car wreck.
Like, if you're married and then you go to this open relationship thing or these parties where they swap and this and that, and then your wife ends up with this dude that just destroys her.
What's the
in
name?
In a good way.
What's
then the you're like, you're like, oh, well, what the hell good am I now?
Oh,
the male porn
ruined.
Star.
Oh, Shane Diesel?
Shane Diesel. It was basically Justin... A girl and Shane Diesel. And just things happened where I just had to sit there. I couldn't be like, no, stop. Oh no, God. Stop. Just horrors.
Yeah, you agreed to it, so.
No, stop. Stop doing that to her. It was horrible. Horrible. It's not a good idea.
Well, what, dare I ask, was the effect on her? Was she like?
We broke up 3 weeks later.
There apparently is a new show on A&E. Called Love Thy Neighbor. It's all about a swingers neighborhood.
Wait a minute, like Alexandria, except instead of zombies outside, it's just a bunch of whores trying to break their
swingers.
Way in. Oh, it's not a good look. Let's go to the phones. We got some people I've been holding for a little bit. Joe, you've been holding Baltimore. Oh, excuse me, Glen Burnie. Good morning, Joe.
Well, hello there. Best case scenario, the guy I work with has a girlfriend for 15 years.
Yeah.
Was cheated on his girlfriend, and the girl found out and ended up, now they've been together for 10 years, all three of them have been together for 10 years. He comes to work with lunches every day. They cook breakfast, dinner, everything. He's got the best life ever.
So you mean a situation that was like adulterous turned into a Three's Company situation?
Yes, he's got the best life ever. And one more thing, at Rick, a bar in Glen Burnie called Rick's, in summertime, a yacht will pull up and a whole bunch of swingers come into the bar dressed half naked, and they just come in and have a good old time. I don't know how you get on the boat, but it seems like an awesome time, but I don't think I could do it with my girlfriend.
Thank you, Jill.
You don't think you could do it, right? You just said?
I don't think I could do it.
Yeah.
I could do it with two girls and a guy, with me, but not with two guys and a girl.
What would you do if you had $1 million?
Me? Two girls, man.
But would you be in an open relationship, or would you like swap partners?
I think you bounced on us. I got somebody calls me jump too. Angie Abingdon, line two. Good morning.
Hello,
Angie. There, love.
Yes. Hi.
Hi there. How are you? And I like the description of your call on the screen. Take it away.
So you kind of just touched on it, but my husband and I have been together about 10 years, and we've talked about it, but we've even thought out a local place that you could. Like go to meet other people.
Taboo.
But our biggest concern was
taboo.
I don't remember what it was called. I don't think it was that.
Taboo.
It was somewhere
definitely
way
taboo
out there.
That's taboo.
But anyway, our biggest concern is what if we hook up with another couple and they stop? I mean, I know what my husband's packing, and I don't know what my capabilities are, but
so what? That's like no harm, no foul. You're like, you win some, you lose some. You like just go away, and no big deal. But if they're like super great,
you're like, oh god, you got to watch.
Like, what
some
if you're
woman
with another guy and he's spectacular, and then your
I
husband
doubt
just
that
never
li- my husband.
Really, nope. Your husband's that good?
That's, yes, and I think I am too. So that's the problem is. We joke about it. I'm like, what if I'm sitting there and I'm watching you having a great time and my partner sucks? What am I supposed to do?
Yeah.
Get up and walk out?
That is a facet. That is a facet of it. It's the opposite of what happened to me, where I just basically got to watch my ex-girlfriend with the T-800, which was a lot of fun. He was sent by Skynet to pleasure my girlfriend in a way I never could. Ugh. 38online.com.